Hi friends, today is 14th May 2020, and most of the life of the people, public, is coming to normalcy. Many hospitals are running, taking care of their patients and emergencies. And whatever knowledge I have gained through internet, through WhatsApp messages and through webinars, I wanted to share few information regarding starting of the OP services, outpatient centers, for the private practitioners. Because most of the patients are suffering and they want their doctor only, their consultant only to attend to them. So these guidelines are through information I got through WhatsApp messages, internet and through webinars. This is purely for outpatient services of the private practitioners. What are the guidelines? Let us discuss these guidelines in 5 parts. First is, the aim of the outpatient services planning is to avoid infection from the healthcare personnel to the patients, and to avoid infection communication from the patients to the healthcare personnel. For this, we have to plan properly in various phases. We'll point out it, put it into 5 points. How to start, how to run the outpatient care or clinics. First and foremost is planning ahead of the services. So tomorrow, if I want to start an outpatient care, I need to plan today how many patients I would like to see, and how many hours I would like to work, and how I have to prepare the premises and sanitization. Everything has to be prepared or planned the day before itself. Every day it should be like that only. How many days there is precautions will be taking, or the COVID infection will be there. We have to plan a day to day. For outpatient care also, we have to take online appointments, and the appointment taken patient only has to be seen, so that in an hour, if we want to see 2 or 3 patients, that would be enough. If you want to work for 3 hours or 4 hours, it is enough. But better to work for limited hours in this problematic period. Not for long hours. Most of us are working from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. or 12 hours a day, seeing the outpatients also. Minimum 8 hours to 10 to 12 hours, most of the outpatient clinics will be running. But in these difficult times, the period has to be curtailed to 3 to 4 hours a day. So we have to plan the consultation for only the appointment taken patients only. This is planning ahead. And second phase is communicating with the patients. Patients should be very well known that they have to come alone to the hospital or with only one attendant. And they should come wearing the masks and gloves. And they should know completely about the sanitization, personal protection, everything, and no touch technique in the clinic. Patients should come in time without keeping the healthcare personnel waiting, so that the other time can be utilized for the other patient, because the doctors or healthcare people will be working for only limited hours. The patient should be on time to the clinic, and they should maintain strictly the timings, and they should not touch the healthcare staff or doctor. They should know that they will not be touched by the healthcare personnel. They should stay away from touching other patients also. So, third point will be modification of the workplace or workflow. In this, the clinic should be very well ventilated. All the windows and the doors should be kept open to allow cross ventilation. All the healthcare person should be protected by protective gear. And so everything should be planned, should be modified, say from the reception or outside area onwards. From the beyond the reception area, near the out gate, one person should stay, one hospital staff should stay and keep the temperature monitoring of the patient first. Then if the patient doesn't have any symptoms, suspicious symptoms of any infection or fever, then only the patient should be allowed inside. Either single patient only or the with only one attendant. Once they cross the gate, once they come to the reception, my advice is to make the payments once the entire assessment of the patient is over, consultation is over, any diagnostics tests are done, the medicines are also distributed, then only one money transaction or only one reception transaction would be better. Not doing two or three transactions to the same patient. That would minimize the contact with the reception people. The clinic should become paperless as maximum as possible. One important thing I would like to tell is regarding the transaction of the money in the reception. The reception personnel should not be infected. For this, we have to encourage the digital payment system, either Paytm or any other card payments and all. And money, if at all it should be accepted, it should not be touched. Zip bag systems, paper bags will be there now, or a separate container should be kept in the reception and ask the patient to put the money notes in those bags, and the staff should not touch. And the, regarding the card payment also, ask the patient only or the attendant to swipe the card themselves, and the reception personnel should clean the credit card machine later with the ethyl alcohol or hypochlorite solution. So regarding acceptance of the money, it's very, very important. Here also the reception personnel should take care, and maximum digital money should be accepted. If it is not possible, put the money in separate containers or zip bags, and at the end of the reception, wearing the gloves, then money should be counted and kept it safe place in the clinic, or should be handed out to the doctor. Once the patient enters, she should be seated in a chair, which is all the seating arrangements should be spaced by 1 meter distance. So in the lobby, not more than 3 to 5 patients should be placed, and one after the other they will be allowed into the doctor's chamber. So once the reception area is over, we have to ask the patient to sanitize her hands in the reception only. And if she doesn't carry any mask or gloves, the clinic should provide masks and gloves to the patient. They should wear. And no touch technique should be used. The doctor sitting in her or his chamber can talk to the patient, keeping a distance of about 1 meter, or the patient can be placed in other OP chamber, and through video calling, the doctor can also see the patient and talk to the patient. There are two methods here. And on doctor's table, it should be kept ready. It should be sanitized thoroughly, and a sanitizer should be there. Doctor should be fully equipped with the PPE and all. What are the things to be worn by the doctor and staff, I'll discuss later. And there should be a transparent shield or plastic sheet between the doctor and the patient, if it is possible. And they should stay away 1 meter apart. And the checkup also should be minimum, with proper sanitization, proper care. Whatever is essential should be examined. And once the patient is examined on the couch sheet should be covering, covering sheet also should be changed once the patient leaves. And If the patients are not there, if the patients are over, till the next patient comes, doctor can relax in another chamber, not in the same consultation chamber. He can go and sit in another chamber. So this is how we have to modify the workflow in the outpatient clinics. And the what are the protective equipment that should be worn by the healthcare personnel? And how should be the sanitation should be done to the clinic? Here, 1% hypochlorite every day fumigation has to be done before starting the clinic and after the closure of the clinic. So this fumigation should be done in the clinics. And then every 3 hours, all the chairs where the patients will be sitting, all the surfaces, reception area, everything, all the tops of surfaces of tables and chairs should be cleaned with 1% hypochlorite solution. And the cleaning personnel should be cleaning the reception area every 3 hours if the OP timings extend. And what are the protective equipment the doctor should wear is a thorough PPE kit. Thorough PPE kit and a face shield and glasses and hood cover and the shoe covers and gloves. The N95 mask respirator. N95 respirator, 5 respirators can be used over a period of 20 days, each one for 4 times. And the PPE gown can be cleaned with 0.5% hypochlorite solution. And doctor should not wear any watch, should not carry any handbag, and should not wear any jewelry. As minimum as possible, easily washable clothes are suitable, because the doctor should go back home, take a bath from head to toe, and soak the dress he or she was wearing in hot water and wash thoroughly then and there itself. If any facility is there in the outpatient clinic for the doctors and health personnel to take bath in the clinic itself, it is better for them to take a bath in the clinic itself and then go back with the fresh clothes. And what the other staff should wear is, they should wear mask, they should wear gloves, they should wear a surgical gown which can be washed every day. So 2 or 3 pairs can be kept, one after the other. Alternately, surgical gowns can be used. Staff should be thoroughly trained before starting the OPD clinics, because they may not be aware. Again and again, we have to teach the staff how to protect themselves, how to protect the patients, how to wear, how to sanitize, and all these things doctor himself has to tell, or a counselor. COVID counselor can be a person designated as COVID care counselor, can be one among the staff can be trained like that, and he can tell. And then these are the precautions that have to be taken. And while seeing the patients, stay safe and stay healthy, because we have to live with corona infection till the vaccine is invented or comes into the market, maybe 6 months or 1 year or 2 years.